Welcome. I hope everyone had a great time in this first ever DevNet Create virtual event. My name is Sean Ng, and I'm the ASEAN Partner Engineering Manager for Cisco. I'm so happy to be here to share what we are doing in the ASEAN Theater. Programmability is becoming very critical in the IT industry, and in Cisco, we continue to open up our platforms with APIs to enable our partners and customers to create applications and integrate our solutions into their workflows. What I would like everyone to start thinking about when you come across a problem where Cisco's solution cannot solve out of the box, take a step back to make an assessment if APIs can do the job. Today, I have two of my colleagues, Sebastian and Humphrey, sharing on their use cases to really help us reimagine the possibilities. Over to you, Sebastian.
Thank you, Sean. Here at Singapore's Cisco Innovation Center, we embark on innovative projects with our customers and our partners. In this project, we use edge computing solutions to create new business models. The project involved outfitting 1,000 buses in Singapore with free Wi-Fi. This would improve customer experience in their daily commutes, but there are challenges of installing equipment on the buses. The power supply has to be installed to run the equipment, the rugged environment that the IoT must operate under, and the need to manage thousands of pieces of hardware and software across Singapore. But most importantly, business owner wants to know how they can offset the cost as well as to create business revenue stream. The bus Wi-Fi project utilized a novel approach to solving the above concerns. The bus Wi-Fi project uses Cisco router for IR829 as the underlying IoT hardware. This is due to its ruggedness, its mobile backhaul, Wi-Fi front end, and edge computing based on IOX inside the router. Another project based out of APJ was able to farm operational data from the physical buses themselves. And this includes GPS locations, driving behavioral data, including speed and braking frequencies. Let us have a look at an overview of the architecture. In each bus, we have an IOX program consisting of Python codes and a Docker container running inside the IR829 Docker. The program connects to a marketing content provider called InstaCheck. It downloads video clips, music files, and survey forms. Commuters with smartphones and tablets are able to consume the content and update their surveys and send them back to the marketing providers. And the IR829 finally redirects the commuters to the website and provides free Wi-Fi access. Some of the features that has not yet been implemented but can be implemented, making the router capture additional data to be sent back to back-end analytics services. This data could be bus driver information, bus locations, driving speed, and fuel consumption, and Wi-Fi data usage. To build your edge application, let us look at the IOX Local Manager. This is a web application that is hosted by the IR829 router itself. This snapshot steps through the underlying edge computing development process. After your IOX program is developed, it can be deployed directly to the router using CI/CD scripts, as you are seeing. Here you can see the execution of the script of this deployment script. And using the IR829 IOX Local Manager, you can see that the Wi-Fi on bus application has been deployed and running successfully. We talk about using the IOX Local Manager to deploy edge computing software directly to the router. But how do we deploy to thousands of routers that are in the buses? For this, we use Cisco Connectics Cloud Services. This dashboard shows that the Cisco Connectics test account is having a gateway and an application running inside one of the buses. The gateway router is up and running with its serial number and model type being displayed. The Wi-Fi on bus application is also running inside the gateway router. Key takeaway here is that edge computing applications can be uploaded to Cisco Connectics and be deployed to many remote gateway routers. For this project, source code comes in the form of configuration commands of IR829, Python, codes, as well as shell scripts. All these artifacts are kept inside Cisco GitHub, and developers are welcome to contribute. Let us finally look at two demos connecting to the Wi-Fi on bus application inside the buses. You can see that on the left-hand side, we have an iPhone connecting to an IR829 on the bus. And on the right-hand side, we have a laptop connecting to another IR829 on another bus. Each router, they are fetching different content from different marketing service providers. With this, I end our short demo. Thank you, and now over to Humphrey.
Thank you very much, Sebastian. My name is Humphrey Chung. I am the consulting systems engineer for Cisco Meraki for Singapore and also Malaysia. And we're going to talk about massive automation using our APIs. And in this case, I have a customer use case where they wanted to do 1,000 VPN tunnels and have them fail over with the click of a button. So I've been at Cisco for 5 years, four of those with Cisco Meraki. I come from the US, and in the US, I helped some of the largest Meraki customers in the world automate their process. In particular, two examples. One was a major fast food restaurant chain, and they are all API. In fact, they're not allowed to do any manual configuration. The other customer is a large worldwide nonprofit organization with 18,000 locations, and they use the API extensively to automate their wireless deployments. Before Cisco, I was a network engineer, so I come from your side. I was a customer, a network engineer for Panda Express, 2,000 store locations in the United States. And I'm also the founder of Router Gods, which is the world's largest Cisco IT meetup group with about 4,500 members. So our customers love the Meraki APIs. They love the dashboard API. They love the massive automation and the scale that it gives them. Some of our well-known brand names down at the bottom, those are our publicly referenceable customers, at least some of them. And you know, being that we have 7 million Meraki devices all over the world, everything from APs, switches, firewalls, even cameras, our customers want and demand an automated way of managing that. Even though they have dashboard, they still want an API. So we have APIs covering everything from splash logins, wireless configuration. In fact, my large customer with 18,000 locations, they use the API to disable Wi-Fi. They disable all the Wi-Fi with one click for all 18,000 locations during important video broadcasts. That way, the people in the locations can concentrate on the satellite feed coming in and not be surfing on Facebook or YouTube at the same time. Also, we have APIs to pull device status. So if you want to know what all your switches are doing, all your switch ports, all your WAN links, we have APIs and webhooks for those. And for this particular demonstration, we're talking about VPN tunnels. We have API endpoints for gathering VPN tunnel information, all the phase one, phase two, the passwords, the encryption methods, along with changing those parameters, change the IP addresses. Now, the Meraki API is super easy to learn. You just go to developer.cisco.com/Meraki. You don't have to actually download anything if you don't want to. You can practice entirely in your browser. Just put in your API key, put in your organization, and you're off and running. We have lots of exercises for you to play around with. You can also do a WebEx Teams demo. So if you use WebEx Teams, you could just type in a simple sentence and you'll get the Meraki API demo right there. We have hundreds of endpoints. And if you use Postman, which you should be using if you're playing around with any type of API development, we already have the Meraki Postman collection. You just download it and you get 300 plus API endpoints. You just fill in your organization key, your API key, and you're off and running, and they cover every Meraki product. Now, I have a large customer in Malaysia with about 1,000 branches all around the country, and they came to me with an interesting problem. They had recently purchased a third-party VPN at a different VPN company, and they wanted to peer up all 1,000 of their branches with that IP address. No, that's pretty easy. We could do that very easily with the API. But the second piece of that was a little bit more challenging. I need to fail over to a secondary IP address or a backup IP address, and I need to do it quickly. I need to do it within a couple minutes of an outage, or if, let's say, the primary data center has some maintenance, if they're taking a server down or something like that. So they came to me with this problem, and I helped them out with the third-party VPN peers. So we have a couple API calls here to get third-party VPN information, the IPsec tunnel information. We also have a put that updates, that changes that information. So what we did is we used a simple JSON, which is just a huge list of IP addresses, passwords, et cetera, pulled from their Meraki dashboard. And we just did a simple copy and replace, a find and replace of the IP address and the passwords. And you just replay that back to the Meraki dashboard. Now, I know that sounds a little complicated, but we have a demo. And I'm going to show you live how to do that right now with my own network and also with Postman. Okay, we're logged into our Meraki dashboard. I'm looking at my own network, and I'm going to go to my VPN peers, and that's under security and site-to-site VPN. I've got 20 peers set up in this case, but you can scale this up to as far as you want to take it, but 20 is fine. And we've got 20 peers, and all of them peer up to 88.88.88. All of the normal IPsec settings like triple dash, SHA-1, key time life, that has already been set. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to simulate a failover where this IP address is no longer available and I need to switch it to another server. I need to repoint all 20 locations or all 1,000 locations to a different IP address. Now, you could do this in dashboard by hand and type it in and save, but if you have 1,000 peers, you don't want to do that. So we're going to open up Postman. And I've got the API call, which is update third-party peers. And I've already put all this information in. I'm just going to click on send. We're going to count it out. It takes about 10 seconds to send. I'll go back to my dashboard and then refresh the screen. And in about 15 to 30 seconds, you'll see that the IP addresses of all my peers will be updated. All 20 peers have been updated to 99.99. And now we're going to fail back to 88.88.88. We'll refresh the screen. And in a couple seconds, all 20 peers are back to normal. It's that easy to do updating of third-party VPN peers by mass scale. Thank you very much for watching this demo. And on behalf of the entire Cisco team, I hope you have a great rest of the DevNet sessions. Definitely take advantage of all the learning, take advantage of all our website resources. Enjoy the rest of the DevNet event, stay safe, and enjoy the rest of your week. Thank you very much.